Hello and welcome to Capitol Report. I'm Shannon Keith and I'm here today with Representative Peter Schweyer, and we are going to talk a bit about what happened with the call centers.
Yeah.
Especially the one right there in the city you represent, Allentown.
Right.
On December 19th.
Right. Right, Shannon, I appreciate this. This is a very important topic. For a little bit of background for folks who haven't been following this perhaps as closely, Pennsylvania, like every state, has unemployment compensation. So when folks are down on their luck, they lose their job through no fault of their own, outsourcing, a company closes, something along those lines, they're able to not lose their house. They're able to continue to put their kids to a doctor if they have an appointment. They're able to have enough to be able to live on as they look for jobs. This is a basic safety net that employees pay for out of their own pockets. And you know, when last year when we had 400 Mack truck workers that were laid off because of a downturn in the truck manufacturing sector, they were able to make those mortgage payments. They were able to make their rent payments. They were able to continue to put food on their table because of the unemployment compensation programs that we have here in Pennsylvania. And just last year, we expanded it to make sure that more folks who are a little bit down on their luck were able to get it. This is progress. This is what we should be doing in a society that cares about people who get up and go to work every day and take care of their families, pay their taxes, and play by the rules. This is what we should be doing. This is certainly the America that I was raised in. And on December 19th, three of those call centers were closed. And they weren't closed because they weren't needed anymore. They were closed because the legislature, specifically the state Senate, failed to act on a bill that we passed in the House that would have continued funding it for one more year as we looked for a final and permanent funding stream and solution to problems. Without getting into too many details about who said what and who did this and what the rationale was and what the public reasoning was versus what the rumors are in the Capitol, the bottom line is 500 state employees lost their jobs on December 19th, including 88 in Allentown. And those 500 state workers, and the 88 of whom who live in and around the city of Allentown, Lehigh Valley, their job was to help people who are down on their luck be able to make their mortgage payment, make their rent payment, put food on the table while they seek employment. There is no justification for this. This is government at its absolute most cynical and absolute worst. And this is why people hate government, because the most basic thing that we're supposed to be able to provide in government is services to the people who pay for it, the taxpayers who are paying for it. And we failed. We collectively, even though the House passed the legislation, I believe it was House Bill 2375, I think that's the number, even though we passed the bill, it's still our fault. It's all of our responsibility. And so now that we are in a new session yesterday, we were sworn in, you know, we all took the oath of office. Now it's time for us to get to work and fund these centers, reopen them. So not only can these 500 people get put back to work, but all the folks that they serve who are down on their luck are able to get the benefits that they deserve and that they pay for. You know, I've heard folks say, and I know I'm monopolizing all of your time, but I'm pretty passionate about this. You know, I've heard folks say that, well, they'll still be able to call. It's an 800 number. They'll get somebody to answer. Because of the reduction of call centers by, again, 500 people, folks are going to be waiting on the phone for hours upon hours upon hours just to be able to register for their benefits. And when you need to go through what's called the hearing process to be able to get just approved for it, that could now take potentially weeks.
There's a backlog.
Mm-hmm. And when you're waiting that long and you need to make a mortgage payment, you're not going to be able to call up your mortgage company that's probably located in some faraway place, part of the United States, probably not located down the street, and say, hey, I'm sorry, Pennsylvania state government decided that it's going to take me 4 more weeks to be able to get my hearing because of this. They're not going to care. Those banks want their money. And so what we're doing is we're putting people's mortgages, their house, their livelihood at risk because we couldn't pass a bill that had overwhelming bipartisan support in the House. The governor said, I will sign as soon as it comes to my desk. we couldn't do it, and it is government at its absolute worst. And we are compelled by not only this is what we're supposed to do as our job, but this is the right and moral thing for us to do, to get our act together, pass this legislation, move it forward. The governor told me personally that he will sign the bill the minute it shows up, and get this done so that we can reopen these centers.
So this is a priority.
This is my number one priority for the legislative session. Yes.
Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching.